We're lucky here at the Children's Hospital to have a fairly large neurology department compared to other programs in the country. Multidisciplinary is actually quite critical for what we do. Because we're taking out a portion of the child's brain, we want to make sure that we as a group assess what problems may occur after brain surgery. So different parts of the brain have different functions, and therefore if we take out a part of the brain, we'd like to know what that's going to do ahead of time. And so the neuropsychologist is important for determining what that part of the brain may do as far as memory or language. The neurosurgeon is important to make sure that what we would like to take out is actually possible, given the fact that there's a lot of complexities in the way that the brain is formed and the drainage for blood and things like this that we as neurologists don't always think about. And then we have rehabilitation doctors who actually help with sort of counseling the families what they might look like after surgery and what sort of therapies they may have to undergo, whether they may need physical therapy, occupational therapy, or speech therapy. And then, of course, we need to get input from all of those teams when we're talking with the families about what they can expect for the future.
My role as the coordinator is to kind of help our families get through the surgical pathway or the process, making sure that they understand kind of what tests need to be completed before surgery, and then making sure that they can come and meet with our whole team, which is really important so that they get that whole understanding of and be able to make a good informed decision as to what's best for their child.
In some ways, the brain is very specific in different areas and what it does. So vision is in the posterior head and brain. You have memory functions that are in the temporal lobes. You have language functions that are in different areas. So the nice thing is that we can actually sort of predict what they might look like after surgery, after all of this testing. So in patients who are undergoing temporal lobe surgery, what's important is to find out how well that temporal lobe works. And we can do that through neuropsychological testing or something called a WADA test, where we put half the brain to sleep and figure out how well the other half works. And so with all of these different steps, we get closer and closer in trying to predict what they're going to look like after surgery. So many children after surgery, they look the same as they did before surgery, they just don't have the seizures. Other children may have a new motor deficit or some sort of a language deficit or memory deficit, and so we oftentimes have to address that, and that's part of the multidisciplinary team, is that we kind of engage rehab, the rehabilitation service, to sort of address some of these issues.
The best part of what I do actually is to see that they're able to gain skills, regain being able to go back to school. There was a patient I took care of who had a hemispherectomy, which is where you remove half of the brain. He wasn't able to play chess prior. That's what he used to love to do. And post-operatively, he was able to do chess tournaments again and was able to continue his ability to participate in classes and things. And so it's really nice to be able to see that child blossom and be able to continue what they were doing prior to the epilepsy starting.
A month or so after surgery, they come back into our multidisciplinary clinic to really see how things are going at home and really kind of figure out, if things aren't going as well, who maybe they need to see or what they need to do to make sure that we can kind of keep them healing and moving along that process of feeling good.